as the winner will go through to the Cup quarterfinals. Kenya 13th, Scotland 12th. It'll be massive for them to get into the top eight. And welcome to the HSBC Los Angeles Sevens. Nelson Oyu on the left. Jamie Fondale brings out Scotland. And alongside me, Hall of Famer, US legend, Zach Test. What an occasion for these two sides. One of them will be in the Cup quarters tomorrow.
Thanks, Dallin. This is what you want to play for in Sevens. One game with your brothers going into the Cup quarterfinals. This game is going to be pound for pound one of the best matches we've seen all day. Two powerhouses. Let's see who comes out on top.
Well, this Kenyan side, earlier results, lost to Samoa 33-14. They've been England 19 points to 14. Nelson Oyu has been their leader. Billy Odhiambo has been fantastic, as has William Bucker. Francisco Gonzalez is our referee from Uruguay. His country will join the series in 2023. And that's Kenyan Corner, the most fabulous supports you will see around the world. They come in there thousands. There they are right there. If you want a party, go join them. Best week of your life. Scotland with Khalid Barreto. They went down to Samoa. They beat England. That's how they find themselves here. It is the final pool game for all these sides. As we wind down here, late afternoon in sunny California, the Golden State says hello to you. Wherever you're tuning in to join this brilliant action, Kenya kicking off from left to right. Scotland receive Khalid Barreto, one of their most instrumental players this season, takes it off the restart. Big hit coming in there. Kenya looking to attack the breakdown on Callum Young. Stays with Robbie Ferguson, one of the vice captains. A little bit of space for Ferguson. Oh, it's a little magician around the side. There was nothing happening. And he rides OU's tackle to the 10. Well supported there by Lee Jones. Scots get the penalty. Barreto taps and goes himself. Khalid Barreto, there's nothing but open space. And the Buffalo can't stop him. And Scotland have the opening try.
Great anticipation by Onyala, understanding what it's going to take to win this game. Scotland, very, very cheeky here. Just running around the breakdown, confusing Kenyan defenders. Little hop skip trying to get his defender away from him. Good fend, good fight. Kenyans almost had it, but a great quick tap from the Scottish, understanding that they're disconnected and beats them to the try line for their first score. Great start for Scotland.
What a player Barreto's been, 23 years of age. The fans love him as well. His conversion is unsuccessful. 5-0, a slender lead for Scotland. Barreto debuted in London 2019, scored against Samoa earlier today. His side ranked 12th in the series, finished 11th in London. But have a good start in this game against Kenya. Leap up and catch this one. William Bucker's back. And he's been instrumental for them today. Two tries against England, once against Samoa. Kenya cut up the middle. Little space there for Vincent Onyala. Move it to the left-hand side. Alvin Otieno, a crowd favourite. Man known as the Water Buffalo. Managed to bring him down early. Billy Odhiambo got 100 tries earlier. Billy the Kid, as he's known, over the halfway line, gets the flick, superb stuff. Tony Amondi's on the end of this one, and it will be a chase for the corner. The cover tackle's excellent, but Nelson Oyu is there on the spot. And Kenya strike back, Shuja Sevens.
Support wins the day for Kenya right there. All started with Billy the Kid slicing through the middle of the Scottish defense, and he had support, a great offload off the ground. You can see the power, the pace. Look, ball's on the ground, but he's trying to keep the ball alive. See his supporting player there, making sure that doesn't get Scottish hand in the way. And then a great finish. Driving his legs again, falling, but looking for support. Gets two hands on it before he gets into touch. Great offload for the first Kenyan try of this game.
Nelson, are you on the spot, the captain? He knows what it takes in a big stage. Member of the Singapore Sevens Championship side for Kenya, their only title. And the fans certainly getting behind their side. This kick keeps it at 5 apiece in this Pool D clash. Remember what's on the line, a place in the Cup quarterfinals. And Nelson Oyu, the never say die support. The men from Nairobi, coached by Damien McGrath. Best performance was both Dubai tournaments quarterfinalists, and then fell away. This one into touch.
Unforced error from Kenya there. Restarts are a critical part of seven rugby, and you've got to make sure that you're putting the ball 10 to give your aerialists a chance to go. Scotland calling for a scrum here, setting up their set piece platform, trying to understand what the Kenyans are going to align and where can they attack.
Still hot up there here on the West Coast. Players have had a great week training near the beaches of California, visiting the red carpet in Hollywood. But now it's all business. Barreto. He's playing stacked behind, a little move. Ferguson comes to the open side, a little bit of space. He's such an elusive customer. And then puts a kick through, but there's no chases. In fact, there is one far, so hidden away, we couldn't even catch it. Big Jordan Edmonds, but he can't pick it up. So can you have this one? This is where they're so dangerous in open field counter with Tony Amondi and Billy Odiambo. Fourth Kenyan to score 100 tries behind Collins and Gerra. Humphrey Kayenga and William Bucko's on the field, but Scotland have it now as they look to cut up the middle. Good support there from Farndale. The Scots could break the deadlock here. Come off.
Just unfortunate there for Kenya. They got the Scotland attacking player isolated, just couldn't quite keep his body position and hold on to that ball to give the referee the picture that he wanted to.
Attention there for Jordan Edmonds in back play. He's the one that followed up that kick. We mentioned Billy the Kid Odiambo getting his 100th try here in Los Angeles.
Yeah, you could just see here. Oh, just a little unfortunate with his left knee. Just gets cut out while he's trying to grab that ball. Great kick chase. It was a great option to see that space. Just unfortunate on the injury.
One of their key players, Jordan Edmonds, scored 4 tries in a match earlier this year. The only player to do so, David Malaga, 2022. So he will go to the side. So winner of this match, confirmation to go to the quarterfinals. Samoa already through. They'll cross over with a pool that features Australia and Argentina.
It's been a great start to this game. Very balanced each other, pound for pound, very equal. It's not going to be about who can handle the momentum, who can be disciplined, who can take care of the ball, go through the phases, and execute when the time is needed. The sun is shining, the heat is on, the pressure's on. Who's going to handle it?
They've played each other 61 times. Scotland have won 28, Kenya 31, so a slender lead in the head-to-head rivalry. But it's all about what's in front of you. 2 to go in the first half. Scotland with their coach, Kieran Beattie, third season as head coach, former Scotland sevens player in 05-06. Jamie Farndale holds the keys, that's for sure. He'd be hired to go to events as Abe Lincoln's lookalike, but here comes Scotland now. For the line, they go over. Robbie Ferguson, he's been threatening all day long, and he's a difference so far.
Fantastic set-piece move from Scotland there. They had great width in their alignment, stretching the connection of the Kenyans, exploiting the disconnect, and using their pace and power to finish. Great job from Ferguson. IDing the body cue of the defender, seeing how he's spinning around. Oyoyo just can't get enough of him. And a great score from Ferguson to get the second try of this match. Well done by Scotland by handling that situation and putting 5 points on the board.
Ferguson gets the goodies done. 10-5. Barreto with the conversion, just to the right-hand side. 5-point game, 90 seconds to go in the first half. Robbie Ferguson, ambassador for Whiteley's Retreat as well. Got married this past December. Now his daughter Ellie is shooting in as well. That kick is a mistake.
Again, just an unforced error on the kickoff. You're giving free possession away to your opponent. Just can't put the ball 10. It's a critical part of the game of sevens. You got to put the ball 10 so your aerialists can have a chance to go compete for that ball in the air and win possession for your squad. Kenya here with a free kick. Going to go with a tap pen. See what type of move they have set up to disconnect the Scotland defense.
Tony Amondi, patient. Drifts across field plan move, sends in the hard running William Bucker. Debut to Hong Kong over a decade ago. Vincent Onyala has a little bit of room to move. Onyala absorbed by a couple of players. Otieno provides big defense and ruck support as well. Kenya with Billy Odiambo. Not a lot of room to move, so he cuts back in. Femi Sefaloran almost has him. Sam Oluech down the short side. Some good fancy footwork from Kenya and the offload. The water buffalo, he'll get it! Well, Alvin Otieno, that is a fact. for a try at the LA Sevens.
Yeah, not a lot of people on this earth is going to stop that man from that far out. Both teams are playing a seven-up defense, so going stretching wide isn't really going to work. You've got to disconnect him, and when Kenya's done down here, they've attacked down that short side. Committed some defenders that had already tackled, and then gets his hands free, finding the water buffalo. And like I said, there is not many people on this earth that's going to stop this big man 5 meters out. Great try for Kenya.
Shuja Sevens with Alvin Otieno out of the Homeboys Rugby Club. They'll be cheering him on in Nairobi as they are here at the stadium in LA. 10 all, kick unsuccessful. That's the halftime whistle. And we're locked up here between Kenya and Scotland, 10 apiece. The Kenyan corner, so loud, so beautiful.
Yeah, a very even match so far between these two outfits. Both know what's at stake. Cup quarterfinals, a ton of them. They just have to do the little things really, really well. Very even matched up so far. It's who's going to do the little things right. Who's going to take care of the ball? And it's going to start from this kickoff. Both teams have made errors at the kickoff. If they can get the ball 10, both have great aerialists to win the ball back for their own team.
Jamie McGrath there giving some words. Took over the coaching role in recent times. Learned to speak some Wahili as well. He's been a journeyman, coached Samoa, Canada, Germany as well.
Yeah, you can see both teams got into the 22 twice and converted twice. But the offloads of Kenya is what's kept them in this game. They keep the ball alive and they get their big, strong power runners in between defenders. It's going to be all about discipline for both sides. Who can take care of the ball? Who wants it more to get to the quarterfinal?
HSBC Los Angeles Sevens here in beautiful Southern California. And a quarterfinal spot is up for grabs between Scotland and Kenya, locked in 10 apiece. This is the 18th USA Sevens event, home to Hollywood. Population 14 million is California. We have so many in support here. Almost every single Kenyan that lives in LA is here. The restart knocked by Scotland, yes it is. Femi Sofalorin almost had it.
You know, it's interesting, Dale, in these pressure games, it's really gonna come down to your fitness, your composure, and your experience. All these guys have been in these situations before. Trust your experience, trust the chemistry you have with your team, and trust your fitness that you've been working so hard all year for these types of moments right here.
Well, it's fitness and it's great to see experience as well. William Bucker back in the frame. First appearance in the 2022 series. He's there with the goggles. Plays just as powerful as he always did. 53rd event for Amaka in Kenya. Finished last in London. Looking to go to the top eight though. They lost to Scotland 22-12 at the Commonwealth Games, but looking for a response here. Up the middle, they rumble. Onyala loops around. Tony Amondi has it. Penalty for Kenya.
Yeah, the Scottish hooker just a little ambitious, trying to get out of that scrum early. The referee picked it up, pinged him for it. Now Kenya can set up their set piece move. They've been really, really good with their tap pen moves. A couple of tries set up off of them. Let's see what they show here today.
Alvin Otieno from the Tokyo Olympics gets it away early. Switch. Oliech. Big contact in midfield. Ferguson's there. Abaka, ball's loose. Baka pounces on it for the men from Africa. Oliech, very flat D, so he's thrown to the deck. Abaka loops around. They do well to contain the Kenyan powerhouse. Vincent Onyala now to the short side. Nelson OU. OU, big bump with Barreto, puts his body on the line. 10 each, 5 to go. Billy the Kid spins out of one. Oniyambo with big buffer on his shoulder. And now Mbaka, oh no, Mbaka throws it into touch.
Those are those moments Willie and Baka will want back. They were had some really good continuity going forward. They were sucking in Scottish defenders. You can see him raising his hand, getting that accountability. Hey, boys, my fault, but let's go after this next job.
William Baka playing his 50th event. It was here in LA in 2020. There he is there in picture again, 32 years of age. Brilliant to see him representing Shusha Sevens. But mistake gives position to Scotland. So what can they conjure up here with Kaleem Barreto? Scotland 12th in the series. Made the cup quarterfinal three times in the USA. But Baka has it now. William Baka sliced down at the 22. Support arrives. Bushamwale looking for the bounce and the spin. Oliyech is on his shoulder. Bushamwale doesn't go down easily. Odiyambo to the right-hand side. Daniel Tabu, there's space there. Nyala flicks it to Nelson Oyu. Oyu almost free. Onyala has space to the left. Throws it down. Oh, it's outstanding. Dazzling the defense. It's Vincent Onyala and Kenya go in front.
What a cheeky little left foot glide step from Onyala there. But it all started from the Kenyans' power. They said, we're going to take you up the middle. Just a little dummy there, and then the left foot step, little slide. Gets Jamie Farndale to bite on it. Great move by Onyala, reading the defensive cue and picking off Farndale. That's going to be a big moment for the Kenyans. They turned the ball over against Scotland, pounded it down the middle, and then a nice cheeky play from Onyala to put them in front.
Celebration start early here. Kenya slipped through, and they're up 15 points to 10 here. Win this, and they're going to the cup quarterfinals along with Samoa crossing over with Australia and Argentina. That's how it sits currently so far. Samoa still to come after this game. They take on England, but Samoa beaten 2-0 so far. England near the bottom there. Samuel Oliyech, man who played international 15s as well for his country, goes a little bit deep, gives a chance for Ferguson and Scotland to come back. Barreto hammers it away. The Scots from their own 22. So Valoran has to go back. Throws it in the field to play. It's a danger ball though, because here it comes with Kenya and Billy Oriyambo. Billy the Kid. The Kid's going to the outside. Oh, this is Kenya. That'll end sublime form. That's what you love to see in the stands as well.
And it all came from the defense of Kenya. Bend not break defense. We'll bend, but we'll get that ball back. And there's no better attacking platform than off of a turnover. The defense is trying to figure out where to go. Billy the Kid spots the disconnect, and boy, does he turn it on. Yeah, he just gets a little isolated, tries to throw the ball in there so he doesn't get thrown into touch. Kenyans are there in support, moving the ball into space, committing their defenders, and Billy Oliyemba puts that ball in the right hand, and no one's catching him from that yard.
Now the man out of the Mwamba RFC in Kenya has scored 101 tries, but this try could be one of the most valuable scores he has for his country. They're up 20 to 10, kick unsuccessful. 2 minutes to go, two scores needed from Scotland. This will give Scotland possession at the halfway line, just what they needed.
Just what Scotland was hoping for, clean possession that they can quick tap from.
Fit Callaghan. Callaghan goes quickly. Flashes it back on the inside. Scotland with Ferguson. Callaghan. David in Malaga 2022. Scrum off as William Baka on his shoulders. You can see it's a penalty. So Demi Sofalaren to Ferguson. Down the chain they work. Paddy Kelly. Ross McCann keeps his feet. 1 minute to go. Scotland need to strike now. Kelly away. Callaghan drifts across, engages a couple defenders, has a half gap, does well to keep in. Quick ball again from Harvey Elms. Ferguson again draws. Kelly looking for the loop, doesn't get it this time. One-handed ball, what a take from Elms. Flicks it back in the field for Scotland. On the outside they go. Finn Callaghan for the corner. He might not have scored. We have confirmation here as we go upstairs.
That's it. Check.
Oh, this is going to be close. Scotland need this try to stay in the game, keep their cup quarterfinal dreams alive. Question is, does he have possession when he puts the ball down? Looks like he keeps his calves just off the whitewash. Is there enough pressure? Looks like there's not enough force.
Yeah,
the ball is lost forward and in goal. Drop out 22.
Sorry again. How are you, sir?
In the act of scoring, he lost the ball forward.
Okay, so we have a knock on. For blue, scrum 5 wide, it's okay.
Not ideal for Scotland. They did everything they needed to do to try and break the Kenya try line. Just a finger was away from 5 points for them. They got to put massive pressure on Kenya here, and Kenya have to maintain this scrum, hold on to possession, 20 seconds left for their cup quarterfinals.
Well, it's a game of inches, isn't it, in Kenya, with 2 second off tries, one from Onyala, one from Odhiambo, as they're up by 10 points. In the final play of the game, the Shuja Sevens will roar here in Los Angeles. Daniel Tabu, the Olympian from 2020, feeds here for the Kenyan side. He's under all sorts of pressure near his own try line.
Release the glove!
Kenya, solid.
I'm rolling.
And they get the penalty to close things out.
He's not rolling.
Great composure by Kenya at the end of this game. Winning the ball at their set piece, winning at the breakdown.
Kenya will walk this one out and they go into the cup quarterfinals in Los Angeles. The men from Nairobi have done it. They've defeated Scotland in this Pool D game, picking up their second victory here in LA, and are winners by 20 points to 10. Congratulations to Kenya and all the supporters around the world. Pool D sees them advance, including the game coming up next.